Hi, welcome to Savi's Fashion Studio. I'm Savita. Usually there is always a little leftover fabric after you cut the fabric for a garment. What do you do with them? If the fabric is good, you don't feel like discarding them and you don't need to because there is so many ways you can use or repurpose them. Just stash the fabric-wise till you have enough to use for a project. For example, this dress is made with all the leftover tiny bits of fabric. In this class, I'll show one of the ways in which I use the leftover fabrics. We'll be making a patchwork stole. This project needs little more patience because we'll be sewing little pieces of fabric together and there's also little bit of hand sewing. But it's very satisfying as you're not throwing the leftover fabrics and also you're creating a unique, beautiful stole. If you want uniform neat blocks in your stole, then you will need to use some calculations like dividing the width of the stole and the length of the stole by the number of blocks. But here I wanted a handmade look, so I've not used too much calculations. Let me show how I did it. Let's start with the class. Here I have some leftover pieces of silk, satin and brocade which I'll be using in this project and I've taken only shades of greens and pinks. Now for example, if this is a leftover fabric, you can just cut it into a neat rectangle or square or just strips of fabric till you use for some project. Again with this leftover. If you want a particular size, then use a template to cut the square or rectangle. But here I'm not looking at any particular size. So you cut the leftover fabrics in this way. Now here if you see, I have some strips of fabric which I'll be using for this project. I'll cut squares of these strips of fabric like this and then join them together. The squares are not equal and I didn't want it to be equal, but if you want it to be equal, you can make a template and cut accordingly. So arrange these blocks till you get the desired width and arrange it such that it's appealing to the eyes. Now in this fabric I want to use this part. So this should be enough. Now what I'll be doing is place the block right on right and sew at quarter inch seam and then open. Again do the same for all the blocks. So I'll have one long strip of fabric, then do the next row and then both of them will be connected here at quarter inch seam. When you arrange the next row, see how you want the design to be arranged. This is how I'll be joining. First finish the first row and then finish the second row and then connect both the rows. So let's do the sewing. If you want, you can pin them together. If you're looking for uniformity in the blocks, then divide the width by the number of blocks that you want. But here I'm not doing that. If you see, this block is longer than the others. And if the width is less, I'll just join a strip here. So that's how I'll be doing this. So do the same for as many rows as you need to make the desired length. And then I'll show how to complete it. After you sew all this, then you will need a backing fabric on which this will be sewn. This is the backing fabric I'll be using. This is 2.25 meters long. And the width is around 26 inches. So let's start sewing. This Juki industrial sewing machine is a new addition to my sewing studio. This has auto lock and thread trimmer option. I'll try to make a detailed video on this soon. Now let's start sewing. You need to lock at the beginning and the end. As I told you, it has that auto lock option. So it has locked in the beginning. And here it is locked and cut the thread. In this way, join all the blocks. Now you see there is some difference here in the two blocks, but that's okay, we can trim it off later. The satin slightly slips as you sew, so you need to hold the fabrics firm with all your fingers. Now in the same way, attach these blocks. If you find it difficult to handle satin or silk, you can try this with cottons as well. Printed or plain cotton works fine. Now if you see here, two rows are done. Now join both of them, placing it right on right and sewing at one of the edges at quarter inch seam. Now iron this flat. Similarly, go on adding rows of fabric to make it long enough. Let me show you after I join all the pieces. I've sewn all the blocks together. Here I've not taken exact measurements for the block. I've just sewn it, and wherever it's less, I've added strips of fabric, as that is the way I wanted it. The other way of doing it is uniformly cutting all the blocks and then putting it together. Now if you see here, this is a big block and I put a small one here. So that's how I've done this. Now if you see on the wrong side, it doesn't look good, so you need to give a backing fabric. And also before that, just fold it in half and then measure the width. Doing this just to make the edges straight. If I want to keep the width at 24 inches, I can mark 12 here and then cut on that line so that the edge becomes straight and you have uniform width throughout. So that's what I'll do. Then I'll trim off on this line, and then we'll be attaching this to the backing fabric and then finish the borders. So let me mark this and cut off and make the edges straight, because as you see here, some places it's a little more because these blocks are not calculated, they're randomly stitched. Now this is the backing fabric. Take the backing fabric 2 inches wider than the patchwork that you've done. Also 2 inches longer than the main fabric. The reason being, we'll be placing this patchwork on the backing fabric in this way, such that we have extra fabric here of 1 inch to fold over and finish the edges. And same will be done in the sides, that is, you'll be folding once and folding again so that 1/2 inch of the backing fabric shows here. This is one of the methods. There are other methods wherein you can take another strip of fabric and finish both the edges together. And before sewing this, it's very important to iron all these fabric blocks so that all the seams are flat. I've already ironed this. Now we'll sew this side first. And the wrong side of the patchwork fabric is facing the wrong side of the backing fabric. So the wrong and wrong is here. Now fold and fold again and pin it if you want, and then sew at this edge. I folded and pinned it here. You can go on doing that, or you can pin all around and then do the sewing. Now I'm sewing the other side. I've pinned all along. Now both sides are sewn. Now sew the other two edges in the same way, that is folding once and again. Pin it in place and then sew. I've finished sewing the edges. Again, I'll be hand sewing stitches all along using this big needle and silk thread. I put 4 strands of thread. This will serve 2 purposes. One is it will give the handmade look, and one more is it will keep both the layers together. I'll be using yellow and blue silk threads. This is optional. Though it takes a lot of time, it gives a nice look. So I'll sew in this way all through the length, and next I'll be sewing with blue thread. This will take a lot of time, so I'll show you once it is complete. The stole is done and this is how it looks. As it's very colorful, I've teamed it with a plain kurti. Thanks for watching this class, and if you like this class, please like, share and subscribe. And for more classes and pattern making tools, please visit our website servicefashionstudio.com. See you soon in the next class. Until then, happy sewing.